President Trump wasted no time kicking his campaign back into high gear with a rally in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Joe Biden emerged from his de facto basement campaign headquarters this week to say this.
This is the most unusual campaign, I think, in modern history. In that, but I start off with the premise, Mike, that I'm going to follow the doc's orders, not just for me, but for the country. And that means that I am not going to be holding rallies.
Sure, doctor's orders. He couldn't draw a crowd anyway. Or maybe it's because Joe just can't go very long without a gaffe.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate for the United States Senate.
President of the United States.
All men and women created by the... Cole, you know the thing.
All right, Chuck. Thank you very much.
All right. It's crisp. Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
You have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, and you ain't black. We choose truth over facts.
No man has the right to raise a hand to a woman in anger other than in self-defense, and that's rarely ever occurs. And so we have to just change the culture, period, and keep punching at it and punching at it and punching at it.
You know, the rapidly rising
even some of his biggest cheerleaders and closest advisors think he should stay off the public stage.
A lot of Democrats think Joe Biden might do well to stay in that basement.
He can stay in the basement and just talk to us, but he's going to have to step up, Biden.
People say all the time, oh, we got to get the vice president out of the basement. He's fine in the basement. Two people see him a day, he's two body people. That's that. And let Trump keep doing what Trump's doing. It's hard for the vice president to break through.
One good thing COVID-19 did, I think, is keep Joe Biden inside. And I'll tell you, no, seriously, because first of all, a campaign is a marathon. You know that. I don't think he was up for a marathon. I think he would have been worn down already in the campaign by this time if he had to be out there every day. Plus, let's be honest, he's a bit of a gaffe machine.
Right now, that may be the best strategy for Joe. He's currently leading in some polls, but it's important to remember he's going to have to come out of hiding at some point. And a lot can change between now and November. The polls, they don't always tell the whole story. Remember, Hillary was beating Trump the entire time in 2016. And when finally Biden does come out of hiding, I'm sure he'll have a lot to say, and it won't be all coherent. The left may be making excuses for Biden now, but it wasn't that long ago when even they were asking same questions we are now. Is Biden fit to be president?
The question is, does he still have his stuff?
And spontaneity.
Yeah, and is he, how sharp is he?
Can he be someone in a long, grueling campaign that can get the ball over the line? There are definitely moments where you listen to Joe Biden and you just wonder.
But now almost no reporter is objective or brave enough to ask Biden about it. Except perhaps for Fox's own Doug McElway, which you did watch.
I'm 65. I don't have the word recollection that I used to have. I forget my train of thought from time to time. You got 12 years on me, sir. Have you been tested for some degree of cognitive decline?
I've been tested and I'm constantly tested. Look, all I got to do is watch me, and I can hardly wait to compare my cognitive capability to the cognitive capability of the man I'm running against. Thank you so much.